Hey guys, Marksman here, and today I have two games that gameplay-wise seem remarkably similar, but I assure you this is not the case. First, I'll talk about the gameplay. Similarly, in both games, your goal is to stop these little dudes from jumping into a fire and gaining superpowers while simultaneously collecting muffins or crates, respectively. This simple premise changes your character's traits while either totally boning you or saving your life, but this is massively different in the games, while the premises are highly similar. Right on the flip side of the shekel, the major difference is progression in each game, and the types of unlocks there are. In Muffin Knight, there is a very tacky leveling up system. The issue I have with it is that the unlocks you acquire are nearly useless until you get the chance to level the ability up, and once you do, it becomes way too overpowered. While in Super Crate Box, the unlocks are acquired basically just by playing the game. The overarching advantage of this is seeing a feeling of progression in the game, and the unlocks are much less superficial and you're more anxious to try out the weapon once you unlock it, and it's not as painful as the disheartenedness you feel in Muffin Knight when you realize that the new weapon you got is about as much fun as untangling your headphones when they've been in your pocket for about 40 years. Now to talk about the gameplay. In a game as fast-paced as this, the controls need to be tight and quick. Super Crate Box absolutely exemplifies this. The controls feel great and are very responsive, like last Friday night. But Muffin Knight just feels floaty. I don't like it too much at all. The problem with it in its entirety is that the gameplay feels a lot slower, controls much worse, and after a bit of research, I found out that Muffin Knight came out a year after Super Crate Box, which can be kind of assumed that they, sorta totally ripped them off. The overarching problem with Muffin Knight is that it tries to take the already well-done gameplay and add in an almost thrown-together leveling up system with perks that grant or add very little to the gameplay and doesn't even do it that well. While the argument about controls you'll only be able to feel for yourself, the one thing that I can give Muffin Knight is the price advantage. As of the time of this recording, the price of Muffin Knight is 99 cents, and Super Crate Box is $1.99 and is also on Steam. Marketing is silly. This could be considered as an advantage, but seeing as how when I was recording the gameplay, while playing Super Crate Box, I was fully immersed and I only stopped after I realized that I had recorded too much. While I was playing Muffin Knight, I was thinking about how much more fun Super Crate Box was. As for the ratings, Muffin Knight earns a 7 out of 10 and Super Crate Box easily earns a 9 out of 10. I'm Marksman, thank you for watching. Links in the description to both games on their iTunes page. Stay frosty, and I will see you later. Hello, friends. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed, please like the video. It really helps me out. And if you want to see more content like this and some of my favorite games, as well as indie game coverage and playthroughs, subscribe and you will indeed see more. I am, of course, Marksman46, and once again, thank you for watching. I hope to see you again.